Okay, in question 10, you're presented with two curves, so y equals x cubed take 4x squared plus 3x plus 1, and y equals x squared take 3x plus 1. And they intersect as shown at the points 2, x equals 2 and x equals 0. And part A says calculate the shaded area. Well, the shaded area is the integral between 2 and 0 where they cross of top curve, which is that one there, take away the bottom curve, which is the parabola. Okay, so on with the maths. Here we have it here, right. So there we have it there, the integral between 2 and 0 of the top curve, x cubed takes 4x squared plus 3x plus 1, take away the bottom curve. Now notice the second curve has to be in a bracket because you're taking away an actual function. Okay, so we can now tidy this up. So x cubed takes 4x squared plus 3x plus 1 just stays the same. Now we're going to now put the negative through these three things. So negative x squared. Now be careful, negative negative is a plus, so that's going to be plus 3x. Negative plus is a negative, so that's just going to be 1. Tidy up that expression and you get x cubed. And you have take 4x squared, take x squared is take 5x squared. And you have plus 3x gives you plus 6x, and the plus 1 and the minus 1s cancel. Okay, so there we have it there, x cubed take 5x squared plus 6x. Okay, right, so to show that you've integrated, I just change to the big square brackets. X cubed is a quarter x to the power of 4, minus 5x squared is minus 5 over 3x cubed, plus 6x becomes 3x squared. So we're now going to put 2 and 0 through these and do a subtraction. So we replace x with 2 there, and you can see there, a quarter times 2 to the power of 4, take 5 over 3 times 2 cubed, plus 3 times 2 squared. Incidentally, putting 0 through is always quite easy because you always get 0 there, so you have 0 there, so we can just ignore that. Okay, 2 to the power of 4 is 16 divided by 4 is 4. Take 5 over 3, 2 cubed is 8. 5 eighths are 40 over 3. 2 squared is 4. 3 fours are 12. Okay, so let's tidy it up. 4 and 12 is 16. Take 40 over 3. Let's change the 16 into so many thirds. 3 sixteens are 48. So 16 is 48 over 3. Take 40 over 3, which is 8 over 3 square units, 8 thirds. Okay, part B. Just show you the question again so you know what we're talking about. Part B. Okay, a line passing through the point of intersection of the curves there and there has equation y is 1 take x. Determine the fraction of the shaded area which lies below the line y equals 1 take x. Now I'm going to take it nice and easy here. I'm actually going to work out that area by doing an integral between the top line of 1 take x, take away the bottom, which is the curve, which is the parabola. So I'm going to integrate between 2 and 0 of 1 take x, take x squared, take 3x plus 1. And here we go. Right, so there's the maths, 1 take x, take. Now just remember, similar to part A, we're going to put the negative through this and see what we get. So we get 1 take x squared, take, plus 3x, take plus is a take 1, and you can see that the 1 and the take 1, they disappear. And you have, now I tend to put the highest power of x first, so it's negative x squared, take x plus 3x is plus 2x. So we're now going to integrate, and just for variety, I've used the big brackets there. Minus x squared, if you integrate that, you get that 2 becomes a 3, minus 1 over 3x cubed, and integrating plus 2x, that integrates to x squared. So we're now going to put 2 through it and the 0 through it, which again gives you 0. Let's see what we get when we put the 2 through it. Negative a third times 2 cubed plus 2 squared. Okay, negative a third times 2 cubed, 2 cubed being 8 again, so that's negative 8 over 3 plus 2 squared is 4. Okay, 3 fours are 12, so 4 is 12 thirds. Negative 8 add 12 is 4, so we have 4 thirds. Now the area below before was eight thirds. The area between the two curves we got before was 8/3. The area below the line y equals 1 take x is 4/3. So it's half of it. 4/3 is half of 8/3. So half of the area lies below the line 1 take x.